to the Chafee College Radio Show, the golden age of radio, live from Cucamonga. Good evening across America. We've got a great show for you tonight with swing music, lots of laughs, and a little trip to the spooky side of the dial. Swan Soap brings the best to radio every night.
Swan Soap feels so right. Swan Soap, such so light. Swan Soap. The soap that floats.
Tonight's lineup is an all-star cavalcade full of silly stories, swinging songs, and scary sagas. Starting with George Burns and Gracie Allen. Tonight's show gives us Gracie's unique perspective on the way the money. Frankie and Pat Aranda Orchestra will have all you ladies swooning with Frank's crooning.
Oh, Frankie!
And the Inner Sanctum will send shivers down your spine.
Sponsored by Swan Soap. Gracie helps George fill out their income tax forms.
Well, George Burns is one of the millions of taxpayers who has up until midnight tonight to file an income tax return, which explains the tense situation as we look in at the Burns' home.
Let's see. Figuring our income tax using California's community property law.
What law, George?
Oh, community property. It's a California law that says half of what I got is yours and half of what you got is mine.
Oh, then how come I only get a quarter of the money we made?
That's just how it works out. Hey, here, I'll show you. I got a dollar and change. Okay, so half of what I got is yours.
50 cents.
Now, half of what you got is mine. How much you got there?
50 cents.
Half of it is mine. Hand it over. There. Now you see how it works.
I see who it works. Now, let's try that again. This time, I'll start with a dollar.
Okay.
Now, half of what I've got is yours. Here's 50 cents.
Why, thank you.
And how does the second part go?
Half of what you got is mine. How much you got there?
50 cents.
I hand it over. Half of it's mine.
You're right, George. Comes out the same way, no matter how you do it.
Say goodnight, Gracie.
Good night, Gracie.
Remember, Swan Soap is the soap that floats.
Those two are a real hoot. Gracie has a different view of the world. And that George is one slick cat.
They are a funny duo, always good for a light moment. Like Swan Soap, light and right and the soap that floats.
Smokes, butt, square, sigs, siggies, stogs, stogies, tabs, backwards, bogies, gorts, willy dillies, darts. These are all nicknames for what, Harry?
Your past girlfriends.
No. No. Cigarettes. So, let's hear about that sweet rush of a good cigarette.
Salutations.
We're your favorite shin-cracking trio.
The Cigarettes.
Here to tell you about Cigaresque, the cigarette for ladies.
now with the patented once, twice, thrice filter that doctors recommend for three times the purity.
So you get none of the risk in all the risque.
That's why Cigaresque is lipstick's best friend.
We're not just blowing smoke here, honeys. Take it from our well-paid team of America's top formerly licensed doctors.
Hi, I'm alleged doctor Steven Snakoil. I have to say alleged for legal reasons, but don't worry. I earned my PhD in medical science from and was honored with the 1946 Real Doctor of the Year Award from. Did you know? In a study conducted somewhere at some time, 4 out of 5 doctors agreed that smoking cigarettes is bad for you. Well, I'm the 5th doctor and I disagree, but the medical community keeps stifling my research. In my studies, every woman who smoked a pack of cigarettes got horribly sick with life-altering damage to their lungs and mental faculties because they are being covertly poisoned by those who want to squash the facts. What are they trying to hide?
Sounds like tomfoolery to me.
Just like how inhaling car exhaust can give your body horsepower, inhaling cigarette smoke will give you human power.
Tell me about it. My Pilates instructor wants me to feel the burn, and boy, do I feel it every time I take a breath.
I had a pack today already. Now I can't remember how I got here. That's one less thing to worry about.
Thanks to cigarettes and a patented once, twice, thrice filter, I'll never be easier again.
Hit it, maestro.
Once you try cigarettes, you'll see it's
twice as nice as the rest, indeed.
Thrice a day, my doctor recommends for me.
A puff or two
from us to you
will make you feel like
a lady.
Hey, cats and kittens. Get ready for the big swing of Pataranda and his orchestra. The boys in the band are frisking the whiskers and are about ready to lay it down.
Wait, frisking the what?
Pataranda and his orchestra. The amazing Pataranda and his orchestra. Those cats really can swing. And of course, Frankie's got the croon that you ladies all swoon for.
Oh, Frankie.
A Get on those silk stockings and get ready to cut a rug.
Yeah, man. And now for a quick word from our sponsor.
Oh, for Pete's sake. I just paid a fortune to get my truck fixed at the dealership, and she's already busted again.
That's one crunchy pickle you're in, ain't it, mister?
Yes, ma'am.
You must feel like you're driving straight into a money pit every day.
Yes, sir.
Hey there, listeners. I'm Allie.
And I'm Ollie. We're the proprietors of Allie and Ollie's Auto Repair and Donuts, serving the Orange Empire with expert truck and tractor work, homemade donuts, and the only public restroom in a 15-mile radius.
For three generations, our independent garage has provided the best automobile repair for local family farmers and steel fabricators. Our history goes back further than Ollie's hairline.
Can you tell me why my truck died so soon after shelling out for a fix?
That's just what happens when you go to a dealership, Yolama Lerwick.
The big name lots will sell you a lemon and then squeeze you like one with needless repairs, and their work speaks for itself, with nothing good to say.
Only Allie and Ollie's can guarantee the job will be done right for the lowest price.
Say, could you help me even if my automobile is stuck here out in the sticks?
Our mobile service trucks can meet you almost anywhere in San Bernardino County, south of the San Gabriel Mountains, from Santa Ana del Chino to Bryn Mawr.
Say, if you guys are so great, how come I've never heard of you before?
We keep our prices so low because we never waste money on advertisements. No billboards, flyers, or magazine spreads. This one is our first and last, so let's just go ahead and get all of our potential taglines out of the way.
Allie and Ollie's Auto Repair and Donuts. Clean work, dirt cheap.
When your brakes break, you need a break, not a headache.
Oil change? More like pocket change.
Other mechanics are sloppy, so let Allie and Ollie take care of your jalopy.
Drive in, have a sprinkle, have a tinkle, and drive out with nary a winkle.
Well, the minute and a half we paid for is just about up, so remember, I'm Ollie.
And I'm Allie.
From Allie and Ollie's Auto Repair and Donuts in Fontana, where Route 66 meets Cherry Avenue.
How about one more tagline for the road?
You got it, mister. How's this one? We can fix your differential, an essential repair of eventual wear with the cost that is circumstantial, so check a residential referential to get a reference for the difference in cost and assistance. Whew.
Maybe we should stick with a shorter one.
How about transmission accomplished?
Sounds better to me.
Well, then have it your way, Yolama Lerwick.
Had to be you. It had to be you. I wander around and finally found somebody who could make me true, could make me blue, and even be glad just to be sad thinking of you. Some others I've seen might never be me, might never be cross. Try to be boss, they wouldn't do. For nobody else thrill. With all your faults, I love you still. It had to be you, wonderful you. It had to be you.
the smooth, velvet voice of Frankie.
But wait, there's more.
What's that creeping up behind you?
Can you hear the door creak open?
Are you lost in a dark and unfamiliar place?
Or have you entered into the inner sanctum?
This is Raymond with a word of warning. If during tonight's broadcast, you look up and find a little spook sitting under your chair, don't be surprised. All little spooks listen to our program to keep up with the latest techniques in haunting. Isn't that true, Mary?
Indeed it is, Mr. Raymond.
Yes, and the thoughtful listener might enjoy cigarettes. One for himself, and one for any spectral visitors that might drop in during the show. It's so refreshing. It could bring the dead back to life.
Oh dear, Mr. Raymond. Cigarettes don't revive people. At least, not like you think. Of course, lots of people do find that cigarettes make their day seem brighter. Yes, it sort of helps them through the housework to sit down between meals now and then, as well as at dinner and supper, and enjoy cigarettes. And the reason why cigarettes are so refreshing is because of that one little word, cigarettes. It's never flat or wishy-washy. So, folks, ask your local grocers for cigarettes. You just don't know how good a smoke can be until you've tried cigarettes.
Yes. And when you leave your grocer, step into the music shop next door and ask him if he's heard the tale of what happened to that world-famous pianist, Pat Aranda. Or better yet, turn the lights down low now and let me tell you. Gather round and let's listen to D'Anthony Boyd in the role of Martin Carroll. It's a stormy night in March. In his Connecticut home, Martin Carroll, world famous concert pianist, lies in his bed, tossing.
I can feel him. There. Again.
Again.
Voice.
Voice.
Am I asleep or awake?
Awake.
Why can't I move my arms?
Arms.
I want to move them, but I can't.
Can't.
Why?
Why?
Who are you?
You?
Why don't you leave me alone?
Alone.
Why do you torture me?
Me?
He's at my throat, sucking my blood.
Blood.
Make me helpless.
Help me. Weak.
Let me go, I tell you, let me go.
I must get up. I must.
I must be awake. He's gone.
Martin, open the door. It's Helen. Martin, are you all right?
Of course, Helen.
Your face is white.
I'm all right, I tell you.
Martin.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to shout.
You knocked over your night table.
I tossed in my sleep. The crash startled me. That's why I cried out.
You haven't been the same ever since you returned from your South American tour. Why don't you tell me what's wrong?
Helen, please go to your room. Don't worry about me.
But Martin.
Please just do as I ask.
Very well.
Helen, try to understand. I don't mean to be angry with you.
That's not what hurt me, Martin. It's that you don't want to tell me what's troubling you.
Nothing's troubling me. My nerves are on edge. Good night, Helen.
Good night.
How could I tell her? How could I tell anyone about this being that is sucking the life out of me? This being that is ruining my talent as a musician and hunts me in my sleep. This being that is urging me to destroy instead of create. This being that is urging me to kill.
Did you find a little spook sitting on the arm of your chair? I warned you. Right, Mary?
Indeed you did, Mr. Raymond.
Tune in next week to find out if Orla comes back to finish Martin off. Or is Orla in Martin's imagination? Or is Martin entered into inner sanctum?
I don't know about you, but I'm going to sleep with one eye open tonight.
Sleep?
Well, looks like we've reached that time to say goodbye to our click cat.
A special thanks to our guests and to you, our faithful listeners. Tune in next Wednesday, April 21st at 5 p.m. for more of Chafee College Radio Show, the golden age of radio, live from Cucamonga. Good night.
Good night.